Hi, my name's John. Welcome back to my channel. This year I've been doing a years-long series on life experiences. I'm at that age where I've experienced quite a lot over the years. So I like to be able to share these things. And I'm hoping that some of it will be good for some people. So this week I'm going to talk about being the good manager and what it means in the 21st century. I think a lot of young people and those new to management think it's all about the control of people. Actually, the truth is it's about control of self. So putting all my experience of management together, here are the things that I wish I knew about management when I started out. The good manager does what they're told. You might be in charge of the team, but you must always also be able to follow the business objectives and what your line manager has asked of you. This means you need to know and understand your role within the business. And are you sharing the role with someone else, or are you completely solo? Discover problems, don't look for them. There's a misconception that you go into this new management job and you have to change something. In fact, it's more impressive to discover a problem and discuss it with your manager. Because sometimes, like I said in my problem solving video 2 weeks ago, that not every problem is a problem just because it looks like it, or just because somebody tells you it is. So those first, that probationary period is about showing the self-constraint of not charging like a bull and trying to change something. Because remember, there's a high chance that your line manager will already know the problems within the team and will be able to guide you. Remember, just because someone on the team points their finger at another individual as the issue, it doesn't necessarily mean it's true. This leads me to my next point. Know when to ask for help and who that help should come from. Asking for help is not a sign of weakness, it's a sign that you're interested in what you're doing and you understand your limitations. There are two other points to this. The first is you have to identify the times when you ask for help. You can't keep going to your line manager for everything. So you need to identify when you can ask and when you need to think for yourself. Help should never be about giving someone else part of your job, unless you are willing to go over the top to really monitor that person, especially if you're new to the team. Because you're solely going to be responsible even for their mistakes. Even if the person is familiar with the team, it doesn't always mean that they're setting out to help. Always remember, as a manager, you have sole responsibility. This, help should always come from above and not below. As a good manager, you'll need to know to stay under the radar. You're the only person on your team that doesn't need to justify anything to anyone about where you are or what you're doing. As long as the staff know where you are, when they need you, then the rest of the time, it doesn't matter. But over the course of the time you were working there, you should be going to see every person you're responsible for, checking that they are okay. Because actually there might be times they need to see you urgently, so actually the usual time is not going to be appropriate. You might need to have that personal conversation. So being able to go and see them, and then they say to you, I need to speak to you, you can do it at times where it's more appropriate as opposed to a general time. And again, this leads me to another point, which is get to know your workers. Well, if you know your workers, you will understand why they're in the places that they are in, why they are doing the work that they are doing. They are also your best asset to keep your job. Understand the staff. If staff have an issue, they may not be able to raise it with you. Because it might be you that's upset them. So the next best person is going to be your line manager or another manager. So when information gets back to you, just appreciate it may not come directly from the person. It may also not have been aimed at ever being shared. There are people who don't want to share when they're upset at work. They just want to get on and do it. So sometimes they will talk to other staff with the intention of airing out frustrations. But it never is intended to get back to anybody else. So actually that information might have taken a very long route back to you, or even to your manager. Don't demand respect and trust of your team. You earn it. When trust and respect is given freely, your authority will be of the highest, and your team will do anything to make you as a manager look good. So it's important that when something goes wrong, you take responsibility and don't blame others. Don't blame somebody on the team. Remember, the loyalty of the team is first and foremost with each other. So by the same token, you must also ensure the team gets credit, both as a team, as an individual, when it goes right. Even if it's you that had the idea, even if you drove it to success. And don't just praise them to their face, tell other managers. Because as a team member, there's nothing more uplifting than to hear another manager from another department praise you because they've heard something really good about you. Finally, to achieve this, you need to be honest. And if you can't be honest, just say nothing. A team will always know if you're being honest. Remember, they talk to each other and to other people in the company, including managers. So think carefully before considering doing a loyalty test on an established team. Ensure you find out people's backgrounds and experience. And for goodness sake, if you lose, be wise not to have a rematch. I hope this has been helpful. I will be back next week with another video, but until then, if you're considering management, there's your guide. Please do subscribe and like the video, and I'll see you again soon.